Hello students, today I am going to explain you about the extraction of iron. Iron is the second most abundant metal in the earth crust. It forms varieties of compound which have various important uses, and this make iron a very, very important element. And all of you know, dear students, iron is also one of the essential elements in biological system. In our hemoglobin, all of you know why blood is red, because it contains hemoglobin. And what is there in hemoglobin? Iron. So iron is very, very essential element in biological system also. Let us see how extraction process takes place. Now, before learning extraction of iron, let us understand the different important terms. Always students are getting confused between minerals and ore. So let us understand first what is minerals. Minerals, which are naturally occurring chemical substance in which metals are occur in the earth crust. Simple word, compound which occurs naturally in the earth crust is called minerals. And what is ore? Ore from which metals can be extracted is called metal ore. Or minerals from which metal is extracted is called ore. Most of the metal which are obtained in nature in the form of oxides and sulfides. And these metals, again, they are obtained from their ores by reduction. So keep it in mind, always from metal oxide, when metal oxide is reduced, then it is getting by which we are getting metal. So here reduction is one of the important process takes place. Children, you have to understand all ores are minerals, but all minerals are not ores. Students, we are going to see occurrence of iron. Iron is very reactive and it is found in nature in the form of oxides, carbonates and sulfides. The main important ore is hematite, that is Fe2O3. Next, that is magnetite. Its formula is Fe3O4. How to keep it in mind, magnetite? Because here iron, it shows magnetic property. So magnetite, Fe3O4. Next, iron pyrites, FeS2. Siderite, FeCO3. The main important ore is hematite. Its formula is Fe2O3. And the iron ore, it contains many impurities. Mainly it contains silica, and its formula is silicon SiO2, and the name is silicon dioxide. Students, for this particular occurrence of iron in nature, always question is asked for 1 mark. Write the formula and name of important ore. So if you are writing, like for example, hematite. So for writing hematite, it contains half mark. And if you write its formula, that is Fe2O3, so it contains half mark. So like this kind of 1 mark question is asked in board exam. Students, in Ellingham diagram, iron, it is below carbon in the reactivity series. So therefore, iron in the ore, it is reduced to iron metal, by heating with carbon. Your carbon, which act as a reducing agent, which reduces other substance and itself gets oxidized. Students, I think this charcoal you have used for the detection of basic radical, that is metals. So you know the role of carbon. So carbon, which act as a reducing agent. Mainly, iron is extracted from hematite, that is Fe2O3. So in extraction of iron, first step, that is concentration. So in concentration, what is happening? The ore, which is crushed, and it is broken into small pieces. And this crushed ore, then it is concentrated with gravity separation process, in which it is continuously washed with water to remove clay and sand. So this is first important step, that is called concentration, which takes place in the extraction of iron. Step number two, that is calcination. In calcination, the ore is heated in absence of air, which is called as calcinide. Students, very oftenly question is asked, what is calcination? So calcination means the ore, it is heated in absence of air or limited supply of air, which is called calcination. And in calcination, what is happening? There is a decomposition of carbonate takes place, that is FeCO3. It decomposed into FeO, that is ferrous oxide and carbon dioxide. And later on, ferrous oxide, again, it is oxidized into ferric oxide, that is 4FeO plus O2, it gives 2Fe2O3, that is ferric oxide. So students, note this point. Under calcination process, first FeCO3 is converted into FeO plus carbon dioxide, that is ferrous oxide and carbon dioxide. And this ferrous oxide is further oxidized into ferric oxide. So 4FeO plus O2 gives 2Fe2O3. Now this is step 3. Step 1 is concentration. Step 2 is calcination, and now we will proceed for the step 3, that is smelting. Now in smelting, what is happening? The concentrated ore, it is mixed with calculated quantity of coke, lime, that is limestone, which is called as calcium carbonate. And this mixture, it is put in the blast furnace from the top. And in blast furnace, there are 5 important reaction takes place. So once again, in smelting, what is happening? The calcinide ore, that is Fe2O3 plus coke and limestone, it is mixed together and it is placed from the top in the blast furnace. Blast furnace, where important 5 reaction takes place. It is a tall cylindrical furnace and it is made up of steel. It is lined inside with fire bricks. You can see here the maximum temperature which is maintained in the blast furnace is 2000 degrees Celsius. So to maintain this high temperature so it is lined inside with fire bricks. It is a narrow at the top, and through this the introduction of iron ore, coke and limestone it is introduced. Extremely on the top you can see there are two outlets. This is for the waste gases. These outlets are for waste gases. At the bottom you can see there is outlet which is for molten iron. Above that there is another outlet towards the right side. This outlet is for the molten slag. Just above that there are two inlet. From this inlet hot air is passed inside the blast furnace. You can see at the base there is maximum temperature, that is 2000 degrees centigrade. At the middle of the blast furnace the temperature is 1500 degrees Celsius, and at the top it is about 800 degrees Celsius. In blast furnace there are five important reaction takes place. Very first reaction, that is formation of carbon monoxide. Near the bottom of this blast furnace coke it burns in air and it form carbon dioxide. So along with the formation of carbon dioxide lots of heat it is produced, and therefore this reaction is called as exothermic reaction. So whenever there is a evolution of heat during formation of product, so such reactions, children, you know that it is called as exothermic reactions. So here the temperature is about 1875 Kelvin. Once the carbon dioxide is produced, further again it react with more coke, and then it is reduced to carbon monoxide. So here reaction it is written C plus O2, it form CO2 along with formation of heat, and further CO2 react with coke and it form carbon monoxide. So this is first reaction which takes place in blast furnace. Third important reaction, that is reduction of hematite to iron. In the upper part of furnace the temperature is maintained between 975 Kelvin to 1075 Kelvin. Here hematite, that is Fe2O3, it is reduced by carbon monoxide to iron. And this molten iron, then it is collected at the bottom of furnace. Chemical reaction is Fe2O3, that is hematite plus three molecules of carbon monoxide, it gives 2Fe. Here Fe is reduced, Fe plus 3 is reduced to Fe plus 2 plus three molecules of carbon dioxide. Now we will understand function of limestone. Limestone, it is nothing but calcium carbonate, that is CaCO3. It acts as a flux to remove sand from hematite in the form of liquid slag. In the middle of the furnace, the temperature is 1075 Kelvin to 1275 Kelvin. So due to high temperature, here what happens, limestone it decomposes and form calcium oxide and carbon dioxide, and this calcium oxide further it react with silica, that is sand, that is SiO2, which is also called as silicon dioxide, which is already present in the ore. So it forms slag. The slag is nothing but calcium silicate, CaSiO3. So now we'll see reaction. First, calcium carbonate due to high temperature, which is called as thermal decomposition, it convert into calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. And further, calcium oxide react with silica, that is sand, and it forms slag, that is CaSiO3, that is calcium silicate. And this slag, it is lighter than molten iron, so it floats over the molten iron, and in a way it protects it from oxidizing back into its oxides. Students, so limestone is also play a very, very important role in the extraction of iron. So first, calcium carbonate decomposes, form calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. This calcium oxide react with sand, which is already present in the ore, and form slag, that is CaSiO3. Now we will understand commercial forms of iron. There are three important commercial forms of iron, known as, according to the, differ in their carbon content. That is, number one, cast iron, which is also known as pig iron. Number two, wrought iron. And number three, steel. In cast iron, the carbon percentage, it is just 2 to 5%. Along with it, there is a trace of other impurities like sulfur, phosphorus, manganese. Second, that is wrought iron. And this wrought iron, it is purest form of iron and it contains only 0.25% of carbon. And third is steel. Steel contains 0.5 to 1.5% of carbon along with varying amount of other elements. So the percentage, students, you have to keep it in mind, what is the percentage of carbon in cast iron, wrought iron and steel iron. Very often question is asked in MCQs. I hope, students, you might be understood the extraction of iron. In a very simple manner, I have explained. I hope you can able to answer. Next slide, it is related to quiz. So if you answer it, practice more and more so you can understand this extraction very well. Thank you.